In this video, I will show you how to calculate the average by category or group in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have some inventory data including the item name, category and available quantity. Now I want to calculate the average item inventory by category or group name. For example, I want to average the total number of items available for men and women categories. To do that, we can use the Excel average if function. The average if function returns the average of all the cells in the range that meet the given criteria. This function accepts three arguments: a range, a criteria, and an optional average range. Let's type an equal sign in the target cell to start the formula. Now type average if followed by an opening bracket. Select the range of the cells containing the category as the first argument. Since we want to find the rows with specific categories, I will type men in the double quotes as the criteria argument. Finally, we want to average the quantity cells, so let's select the quantity cells as the third average range argument. Type the closing bracket and hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the average numbers by category men. Instead of hard coding the category text, we can refer to a cell containing the category name like this. Let's also quickly average the numbers by group woman. When we change the quantity of any item, the average will also be calculated automatically like this. But when we add a new row for an item, the average will not be calculated automatically. To fix this, I will change the cell references to column references in the formula. To do that, I will remove the numbers after the column name from the references in the formula like this. As you can see, now the category average will be calculated automatically when we add new items to the table. We can also use the average ifs function instead of the average if function to calculate the average. The average ifs function returns the average of all the cells in the range that meet multiple criteria. We can specify more than one pair of range and criteria arguments to this function. Please note that the order of the arguments of this function is different from the average if function. Since we want to average the quantity cells, I will select the range of the cells containing the quantity as the first average range argument. We want to apply the criteria to the group cells, so I will select the group cells as the second criteria range argument. Finally, I will type the group name as the third criteria argument. Type the closing bracket and hit the enter key to complete the formula. As you can see, we now have the average of values having the specified group name. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.